boast, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the word of the cross is the power of God to us who have been saved. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Today we celebrate the Feast of the North American Martyrs. These are Jesuit martyrs who came to both Canada and to the United States early in, even before the country had become the United States. They were here giving that call to evangelization to the Iroquois peoples, the Huron peoples. They suffered a lot of torture, a lot of very horrendous experiences. One of them, even after his friends had been killed by the Iroquois, was able to escape, was able to go back to Europe. He had, during his time in North America, he had his fingers chewed off as one of the tortures, chewed off by the Iroquois warriors. And so that question came. He's now safe, he's back in Europe, but he says, I want to go back. I want to go back and I want to bring the love of Jesus Christ to the very people that ate my fingers, the very people that killed my friends, because they need to know the love of God. And ultimately he would go back, he would die, as all these other martyrs as well. But there's that beautiful image of the blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church. And so just a couple miles away from where he died, there was a beautiful little girl who was born named Katera Tekakwitha. And she was given this powerful grace to become a virgin consecrated to the Lord, very, very unique in the whole history of the Native American peoples, and became an amazing saint. And many people say that through the witness and the blood of these martyrs that were willing to go back into certain doom and destruction because they wanted to share the love of God, even though they would probably be killed, God honored that and brought about a great renewal through Saint Katera Tekakwitha, who has touched many, many people within her own tribe and further. So never underestimate the power of grace. Never underestimate how might say, well, it's not efficient to have these guys go back and die. And yet the Lord says, anyone gives their heart to the Lord, even by a martyrdom of blood or a white martyrdom, which many of us can go through as well, through persecution, through suffering, that the Lord sees all of that. And none of it is ever wasted. It becomes a powerful force for good within our broken world. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who chose to manifest the blessed hope of your eternal kingdom by the toil of Saints John de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and their companions, by the shedding of their blood, graciously grant that through their intercession, the faith of Christians may be strengthened day by day. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you once lived following the age of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work and the disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the desires of our flesh, following the wishes of the flesh and the impulses, and we were by nature children of wrath, like the rest. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for good works, that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord made us, we belong to him. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Know that the Lord is God. He made us, his we are, his people, the flock he tends. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Give thanks to him, bless his name, for he is good. The Lord, whose kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbiter?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do? For I do not have space to store my harvest." And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall say to myself, 'Now, as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong?' Thus will it be for the one who stores up treasure for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You'll notice throughout our culture, throughout different stories that you've heard, there are so many things that actually come from Scripture. So many phrases: rest, eat, drink, and be merry. It's right here. But notice what's being said here. It's not so much just do whatever. Remember, rest, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we'll die. That's the full expression that's there. But it comes actually for this moment here where it says, be careful that you just eat, drink, and be merry, because are you storing up treasure in heaven? Or are you just building big barns here to have more and more and more? And this powerful, really, it's a proverb here, is you don't take any of that with you. You only take the good works that have been fashioned in love through grace, that is your treasure in heaven. So it's something for us to think about, especially as we move into this moment of autumn is moving through. In time, we're going to hit winter, and the readings will start talking about the end of the world. We'll start talking about, get ready, Christ is coming. Ultimately lead to that big, giant, final feast day during ordinary time, which is Christ the King, leading to the fact that he has to be the Lord of your heart. He is the King of the universe, but is he the King of your space? Because that's the powerful thing about the Lord, is that the Lord is ruler of all, but to us creatures, were made in his image and likeness, he gives us the ability to, in a sense, create a force field of freedom to say, you are not welcomed in my spot. That's a terrifying thing, that we have that ability to be able to do that. And so we always have to examine our heart to say, am I keeping God out? Because if I am, he'll stay out. He wants to come. But he's a gentleman that always respects our free will. Are we taking the time now that is temporary? If you think about it, every single second right now, you're moving closer to your death. It's not the happiest thing to think about, but every single second, you're moving towards the moment in which you will breathe your last. That's 100% certain. There is, as some people say, sort of humorously, there is 100% mortality rate. You're always going to move towards your death. And yet, isn't it interesting how we don't like to think about that? And we try to have things that get in our way to help us forget that real truth. So we store up things, or we try to find time-saving things, or even, you know, do things to try to keep ourselves young forever and ever and ever. And yet all of it is keeping us from that reality of one day we will die. But if we're living for that moment now, then that actually will be a wonderful reunion with the God that's been calling us all along. Christian message changes the way that we look at death. We don't have to fear it anymore. But we can say, death, where is your victory? Where is your sting? Christ took it away from you. And now I can actually move towards my death, whether it be through old age or through other means. The martyrs today, their lives were cut short. They probably were in their 40s, maybe, in their 30s. Maybe even younger. And yet they moved in that way, in such a way that they didn't fear that death. One of them even went back into the death area because they said, it doesn't matter. Because ultimately, eternal life is waiting. And that's worth living my life now for, versus the other way around. What profit a man if he gained the whole world and yet forfeit his soul? Who would want to, even though we think of this as such a long time, but a flash in the pan versus eternity? And why are we so focused on preserving the flash in the pan and not spending our energy on eternity? Have you ever noticed that? It's sort of like we're focusing on a little tiny speck and we're putting all of our energy in there. Let's say all of your savings, let's say you're using it to make one little tiny corner of your house perfect and immaculate and gold and shiny and has the most incredible things to it. You're putting all of your wealth right there. And yet the whole rest of your house, the walls falling off, there's no roof right there, there's no floor anymore, and yet you have a perfectly preserved corner that's about this big. Do you see how ridiculous that would be? Because even if that whole corner was perfectly preserved, if everything else falls down, then that falls down. And yet, why is it the way we live our life, the way that we use our time? Our time tells us that we're actually focusing on the corner. And yet being able to sort of put that to the side and say, let me focus now on the whole house, which is my soul. Because that ultimately is what matters in the end. So, a quick word now about the core of this gospel message that we need to take within our heart in order to focus on the whole house instead of a little speck of our temporality right now. The letter to the Ephesians today, this is Ephesians 2. This would be a great one to go back over, because what St. Paul does here is he gives you the kerygma. He gives you the core kernel of the gospel message. This is actually like when we talk about, for those of you who have gone through Alpha before, Alpha means beginning. But what's being taught is basically the kernel message of what we believe as Christians. It's actually all here, just in a couple verses. This is what we talk about in Light of the World, or in the different retreats that you've probably been on before. It goes back to this passage, which is another one of these John 3:16 passages. This is like Paul's John 3:16. So it just says, you were dead in your transgressions and sins. You were following the age of the world, the ruler of the power of the air, spirit that is at work in the disobedient, and you were living among them in the desires of the flesh, following the wishes of the flesh and the impulses. So that's what we talk about: the world, the flesh, and the devil, the three enemies against what we were made for, communion with God. That's what's being said here. So we sort of have all of that, and because of that, you were dead. St. Paul says it very, very clearly. You didn't have life anymore. You were a corpse. You were a zombie. You were the living dead walking without any life within you. But God was rich in mercy because of the great love that he had for us, brought us to life in Christ. And then it goes on here saying he pours out this grace. It's not something that we can earn, something that we can work towards, but what that grace does is it empowers us to live out good works. We're made and created to be able to live out this new life in the Spirit. That's what's being said here. So I would encourage you just to go back to it, delve into it. And this is what we need to learn, how to be able to hold on to, and then how to be able to share with one another. If you're wondering, like, how do I preach the gospel? Study this and learn, how do I, in a sense, say, this is who I was, dead. This is how Christ came into my life. And this is how I'm living now. And if you learn how to take your own experience and bring that into this kerygma, it's a very powerful way of preaching the gospel just in 2 minutes. So that's something maybe to try and pray over. Guided by the Holy Spirit in leading their flocks. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, international organizations, and for all who seek an increase in charity throughout the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all God's children who lack the basic necessities of life, may their needs be met and may they be blessed with the strength and support they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit guide our actions in making this house of worship a welcoming place. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in the light of faith, may they rest in the peace and love of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Camille Oliver Hoffman, for whom I've been asked to offer this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the intention of our Holy Father during this month of October, that by the virtue of baptism, the laity, especially women, may participate more in areas of responsibility in the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions within your heart and within Our Lady's intercessory box, as we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Ever-loving and gracious Father, we humbly ask that you hear and answer the petitions we place before you today, through your Son, Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And the Lord has sent the sacrifice at your hand, for the praise and the glory of his name, for ours and the good of all Church.
As we venerate the passion of your martyrs, John de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and companions, grant that through the sacrifice, O Lord, we may proclaim worthily the death of your only begotten Son, who, not content with encouraging the martyrs by word, strengthen them likewise by example, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised, Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we with all the hosts of angels cry out, and without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her into the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Vitolis peccata mundi, miserere dolomis. Agnus Dei, vitolis peccata mundi, miserere dolomis. Agnus Dei, vitolis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Let us pray. Having fed upon heavenly delights, we humbly ask you, O Lord, that by the example of blessed Saint John de Brebeuf, Saint Isaac Jogues, and companions, we may bear in our hearts the marks of your Son's charity and suffering, and ever enjoy the fruit of perpetual peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.